Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. And in today's video, we'll be understanding one of the most useful tips of Illustrator CS6, the Perspective Grid tool. This tool is one of the most useful and powerful tools in Illustrator. With the help of this tool, you can create three-dimensional objects very easily. So, if you see on the left-hand side, I have created a three-dimensional objects here with the help of the Perspective Grid tool. I have used text, I have used rectangle and few more options. So we'll make this, but let's understand the basics of Perspective Grid tool. This is the overview of Perspective Grid tool, and if you select this Perspective Grid tool here, you can edit the angles, you can even move the objects independently. So let's hide this for a while and create a new grid. So to do that, we'll go and just click the Perspective Grid tool and the grid will be there. You can even go to view perspective grid, and here you got lot of option: 1 point perspective, 2 point perspective, 3 point perspective. So you can create any kind of perspective view. So we'll be working on 2 point perspective, so we can go and click here to create the grid. But we have one more option here: define grid tool. Here it is custom. You can customize your angle, thickness, scale ratio, everything, and the whether you want 1 point, 2 point, 3 point. We want 2 point. Let's keep this 1:1. The thickness of the grid be 30 points, angle this much, and click OK. So our grid is ready. You can edit it here. You can even change the angle view by selecting this and just move it up and down and side and right and left side. That's all. So this is our grid, and our perspective view is this. So let's keep this as the perspective view and make our perspective objects. So to do that, first we'll type the text. So let's take the text tool and type out our words. So let's type perspective, 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 VIEW. Just scale it up, and we can change the font here. Just select this, go there and just change the fonts. Check the post, and you can even change the thickness. Okay, let's keep it that way. Duplicate this one. Let's type like graphic design, GRAPHIC DESIGN, design by CREATNPROCESS, and let's change the font to something else, like this, any font, that's your choice. Let's duplicate one more time, alt and drag out, select this and type Illustrator tips. And let's change the font to something bold and much more thicker. Let's keep this way. Okay, so our font is ready. We need the box. So to create the box, we need to draw the rectangle in such a way that it goes along the grid. To do that, there is a small cube here. You can decide which face you want to select. Just go select the perspective grid tool and select the side, or select the face where you want to draw your rectangle. So we want to draw a rectangle this side, so just select this side, select the rectangle and just draw it out, and it will automatically snap over the grid. And you can even elongate it, you can make it bigger. Let's keep it that way. Let's fill this color with some gradient color. Now let's draw one more. We need our rectangle to be here, so we'll with the grid perspective grid selection tool selected, select the face, this face, go to rectangle and zoom in, and let's draw out the rectangle. So just draw out and place it there and snap, and it will automatically snap over there. And let's fill this with the same gradient color, and with the gradient tool you can adjust the color like this or different form. And once you have got that, we need this check strips. So we'll just select this object, go to object path and split into grids. So in the split into grid, you got rows and columns. Let make it 4x4 and click OK. So you got a rectangle with 4x4 faces. So we'll just select randomly the pieces and fill it with some different color. Let's fill this with yellow color. And let's select this all and group it, Control G. And with the perspective selection tool, just click and play, snap this object over the grid. And you can see that it is already slapped. You can scale it up or down inside the grid very easily. Just place it there. So our box is ready. So the next step is to place this text over the grid, and we have to decide in which face you want to place the text. We want to place this text there. So just before that, just bring this text over there, place it, arrange it over the front. Now go to the perspective selection tool, select this face and just place it there, and you can just and it will automatically slap there, snap. In the same way, we select this text, bring it over there, arrange it in the front, and with the perspective selection tool, with the face selected here, just snap it there. Again, bring this text this side, arrange it to the front, and this time we want this text to be placed on this face. So we'll select the perspective selection tool, select this face, and just click and snap it there. And your object will be snapped. Now the next step is to scale up and down. And in perspective grid, it is very easy to scale it up. You just select it and scale up, and you can even elongate it, like selecting this and just make it much longer. Place it there in such a way that it's look better. And you can even scale it up. Now you can even select this, and if it's going outside, just scale it down a bit, place it properly. If you feel that it's you want a longer one, just elongate it, place it perfectly, scale it down if it's quite big, and place it properly. Now this one, you can place it, you can scale it down if it's very big, just place it you can independently place it anywhere. Now one more thing we are left with is we need this small cube rectangle here. So there is no need to worry about that. We can independently draw it. Just click this, our face is selected. So we have to just go in and draw it out, and the small strip is made. You can go in and you can just with this selection tool, you can just drag and place in the place where you want your object to be. And the end, if you want to see your object independently, just hide this object by selecting this and hide out this object, and your object is ready. Finally, over here I have given some drop shadow. You can give that by just going and selecting this effect, stylize, drop shadow, okay. And your drop shadow will be formed here. You can see in the same way I have selected this effect stylize drop shadow, preview it, change the angle if you want. I'll keep this one and just preview it how it looks, and if it's okay, then click OK and group this up. And if you feel that the texts are quite bigger, you can again just go and select this perspective view. Just remove this one, we don't need this, hide this one, just click and select the perspective view, select this one, scale it down a bit, this one, scale it down and place it where you want your object to be. Scale it up. Okay, so later on also you can edit it very easily. So this is how you can create your three-dimensional objects using the perspective grid tool very easily, very simple. I hope this tutorial was useful, and don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on more designing tutorials, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.